हेलो, टुडे वी शैल सी द कोंड्रम कंस्ट्रक्शन। लेट अस फर्स्ट लुक एट द फंक्शन ऑफ द कोंड्रम एंड वॉट एवर द ड्राइव इज देयर, द फंक्शन वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इट, विल जस्ट रिपीट। एज डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर, द स्पीड ऑफ द बॉबिन मस्ट रिड्यूस एज ईच लेयर ऑन द बॉबिन इज बिल्ट। दिस वी नो। दिस इज अचीव्ड बाय शिफ्टिंग द कोंड्रम बेल्ट एंड ट्रांसमिटिंग द रिड्यूस स्पीड, दैट इज द एक्सेस स्पीड, टू द डिफरेंशियल बॉक्स दैट फर्दर ड्राइव्स द बॉबिन। Here the conundrum speed is constant from the start to the end of the bobbin belt, and the sum of the diameters of the top and bottom conundrums put together should be a constant. So with this, let us see the conditions for the construction of the conundrums. The diameter of the bobbin increases linearly with the addition of each layer, and therefore the speed of the bottom conundrum must decrease linearly with the increase in the bobbin diameter. So as the bobbin diameter increases, the conundrum speed, the bottom conundrum speed must decrease and in a linear fashion. So if D1 and D2 are the diameters of the top conundrum and bottom conundrums respectively, in that case D1 plus D2 must be constant. Say, let us say it is 10.5 inches. The top conundrum and the bottom conundrum at both the ends, it is 7 and 3.5 respectively. So the total would be 7 plus 3.5 on one end, and similarly on the other hand it would be 3.5 plus 7. So adding this, it would come to 10.5 inches. So with this, let also the conundrum speed be 100 rpm. So how to calculate the conundrum diameter? So this has been explained here. Column 1 shows the linear increase in bobbin diameter with the addition of each layer, that is 0.25 inches per layer. So we can see in the table, the first column shows with every layer 0.25 inch has been added, and we have formed a table which gives us the bobbin diameter increasing with each layer up to 4 inches. So bottom conundrum speed at the beginning of the bobbin, if the top conundrum speed that we have just mentioned is say 100 rpm, then in that case, in the beginning, the belt would be at a position where the top conundrum is of 7 inches in diameter and bottom conundrum would be 3.5 inches in diameter. So the bottom conundrum speed will be 100 into driver upon driven, that is 7 upon 3.5, that's 200 rpm. So this is our first second column, first row that we have filled up. So since bobbin speeds must reduce inversely with the increase in diameter, the bottom conundrum speed must reduce in the inverse of the increase in these bobbin diameters, which we have just seen. So how to calculate this? Bottom conundrum speed for building the layers is, since it is in the beginning, it is 200. So with every layer that is added, it will reduce in this fashion, 200 into 1 upon bobbin diameter. That is in the second row of the second column, it would be calculated as 160 rpm. So in a similar way, calculating the entire column over here, we get all these figures. So now the next column is calculating the top conundrum diameter in inches. So in the beginning, the top conundrum diameter is 7 inches that we have already mentioned. So if this top conundrum diameter is say x, and we are going to calculate the top conundrum diameters, and the bottom conundrum diameter in the beginning would be 3.5. With this background, if x is the top conundrum diameter, then in that case we know that x into the speed into the diameter is equal to 10.5 minus x, that's the diameter, multiplied by the speed. So x into 100, that is the diameter into the speed that is there, is equal to 10.5 minus x into 160. So this should be equal, because surface speeds of the top conundrum and the bottom conundrum will be equal. We are ignoring, we are cancelling pi from either side. So it is pi into d into n. So when we get this equation, when we solve it, we get the diameter as 6.4615, and we have entered this in. We calculate for all the entire column here, and the third column can be filled up. So the last column that is there, it is 10.5 minus the top conundrum diameters. So we get the last column here. So this is how we calculate the diameters of the top and the bottom conundrum. With this, we can construct on a graph paper. We can take the length of the top and the bottom conundrum as say, 13 divisions, and then taking all the above values, we trace them, and we can get the top conundrum profile as well as the bottom conundrum profile. So as we can see, the top conundrum profile, it is in this manner. It is slightly concave, and the bottom conundrum is convex. So with this, we go further in the discussion. Let us talk about what is hyperbolic cones and what are straight faced cones. The conundrum shape that is constructed is hyperbolic, that is concave and convex shapes. What we have just seen is this type, that is hyperbolic cone. So this is the image of that hyperbolic cone which was there on the conventional roving frame. We can see the profile here, top conundrum, which is concave and convex. In this type of conundrum, the belt has to move on the surface that is of varying inclination. So in this case, if the belt has to move, we can easily see over here that it has to move on a surface that is not flat, or it is slightly inclined. And therefore, in this place, instead, if we had a straight surface cone, it would be more preferable. That is something like this, where the faces or the surface is straight. It would be more preferable from the point of view of shifting of the belt. But in this second case and the first case here, there will be some slight difference. There is a difference in the amount of shift of the belt. In case of hyperbolic, that is the first type of conundrums, the belt shifts by a constant amount. Since they are designed or constructed as per the required bobbin speeds by taking the appropriate diameters, by whatever table we have formed earlier, using that we have actually taken those diameters and traced them at equal distances, and that is what the construction of the conundrum we have got. And therefore, the conundrum belt will be shifting by exactly the same amounts every time with the buildup of each layer on the bobbin. So the distances are fixed along the length of the conundrum by which the belt will shift. But when it comes to the straight-faced conundrum, in this case, the belt will need to be shifted in varying amounts. So to get the same diameters and or the same speeds in this case, in the second case, we might have to shift the belt in varying amounts. That it would not be, that means it would not be equal from beginning to the end. The amounts would vary, and it will be in such a manner that it will be large steps in the beginning and smaller steps later on. So with this, we come to the end of this lecture on conundrum construction. Thank you.